Hello everyone. In one of my previous videos, someone requested that we look at the Cobra. Well, the Cobra really doesn't lend itself to the 1D, but because it really comes into its own when you have a thrust-to-weight ratio 1 over 1. But it probably originated when someone was kicking the ball about the yard to see how slow we can loop the airplane. And so here we go, slow loops. You can see on the left side of the screen, that's the airspeed tape, down to zero there. So in the 1D you can do a loop starting about 90 knots. It's not very pretty, but you can get it around. And then someone probably thought, well, it'd be probably more fun if we kicked the ball against the wall. And so in this case, we get the Cobra, pull it just past vertical, and then once we're past vertical, we stop the loop and push back. So that's kind of where all this probably started. I spoke to a guy who claimed to have invented it in a Sukhoi. I never did follow up with him about his technique or anything like that. I was too busy trying not to fumble this airplane. So that's the slow loop. Before we do the actual Cobra though, let's make sure we have an exit strategy. So this is the slow Humpty, and in fact it has some practical use for those of you doing competitions, because if you end up slow at the top, you can salvage a Humpty even with almost no airspeed. So what happens is we're so used to having a pull back right rudder, push forward left rudder kind of built into our system. In fact, when you've got no airspeed and you want gyroscopics to help you, when you push forward at the top of the Humpty, and we'll watch watch this one here, we're pulling back, we go vertical, and what happens at the top, we've got almost no airspeed, and so if we try normally, we just torque off the top, but here we push full forward and full right rudder, and the gyroscopic pushes you over the top. And you probably get scored for that, you won't get zero. So here we go again, pulling up, so our airspeed is dropping off, and we're going to hold it till we've got much less airspeed than we normally would for Humpty. Push full forward and full right rudder, and over she goes. So that's our exit strategy, and we're going to need it to do the Cobra anyway, but if something goes wrong, we've got to have that, we practice a few of these so that our muscle memory is established and we know what to do when we get to these situations. Of course it's the opposite when you pull, but what's happening, you push on the right rudder, the gyroscopics helps push the nose down faster. The other thing you notice, here we go, notice the airspeed dropping off. On the right is the altitude, push full forward, full right rudder, and around she goes. Of course, try not to make this mistake when you're flying normally, because you know, that rudder input is opposite of what you've been learning your entire lives. And just for grins, practice going the other way a couple of times. And for some reason, the elevator is a lot more effective pulling than pushing on a 1D. So you don't really need an awful lot of left rudder to help you over the top at very low airspeed. Okay. So the next figure to practice is kind of a figure on its own. It's kind of a forward tumble. So I'm pulling to the right here, right bank, pulling vertical. That leaves the left wing high, so you feed in some left rudder. And I'll explain why in a moment. So now you've got left rudder, push forward, right rudder, and over the top and on your back. So that's the forward tumble. And the reason for starting with a right bank is as you pull up, you have to feed left rudder to bring the left wing back down to the horizon. And you try to time it so that as your wing reaches the horizon, that's about when you want to pivot. And over she goes, right rudder. Quite a bit of aileron. The aileron still work because it's in the prop wash. And you come right over onto your back. Now, if you didn't have any right bank, you'd run out because you'll have to put right rudder in there to keep the wing on the horizon. And so you won't have enough right rudder for the gyroscopics to help push your nose back over the horizon on your back. So that's the reason why you do it. Once again, watch the airspeed drop off to almost nothing. Because we're not looking at the airspeed when we're actually flying. No airspeed. And so what's happening here, the air is actually wrapping around and pushing the back of your tail so that you flop over onto your back. Once again, pulling to the right, feeding in left rudder. So now you've got lots of right rudder to play with. Push forward, full stick, full right rudder, and over she goes. Recovery is quite simple. Nose back down, get her flying again. There's all sorts of stuff you can do after this. You can do spins and knife edges and all sorts of stuff. But just for basic practicing for the next step, we just recover normally. Alright, so that's enough practicing. Let's get on to the actual cobras, or what can be considered cobra in a 1D. Pull over, pass vertical, push forward, right rudder, recover. So looking in the cockpit, and you notice that the stick comes back so far, and then suddenly it just goes loose, and the stick comes all the way back. That's normal. That's the airflow just backing up over the elevator. There you go. So one more shot at it. Pull over, pass vertical, hang for as long as you dare, push forward. And the airflow will help you come back forward too, because you're still moving forward. The air is flowing on the belly of the airplane. So really, you practice this and develop it as best as you can. Here once more, you notice it comes back and then suddenly goes boom into your belly. Hang, full forward, full right, and we're done. There you go, Cobra. Have fun.